kind of vanilla team for me as I've kind of like gone through the record books and think about it. I don't think we've given much love or talked about this team much. Last year, they finished 7-9. This year, I have them finishing 7-10. Now, I like Kirk Cousins more than most because I think he's an okay quarterback. He, you know, he's consistently 3,000 yards, 30 touchdowns somehow. Got two dynamic receivers on the outside with Adam Thielen and now Justin Jefferson, who had a great rookie year. Dalvin Cook there in the backfield. Their offense can roll, but last year that wasn't the problem for this team. Their defense, which is usually tried and true under Mike Zimmer, was not. And I don't think it's going to get much better because literally they released their 2020 first round pick today as things happen today because of a domestic violence incident. So I don't know what more to say about the Vikings. Taylor, what are your thoughts on them?
I think you're spot on. I think the Vikings offense, like you said, is not a problem. They've got a bunch of great guys. And I don't think Kirk Cousins is that bad of a quarterback either. So I think that's good. Defense probably going to be the problem. And then I also feel like Mike Zimmer has got to be feeling the pressure. I think he is the last tenured coach in all the NFL that hasn't won a ring. If I were him, I'd be feeling the pressure to get there or at least make the playoffs or something. But I mean, when you've got a Green Bay in your division, it's and Aaron Rodgers, it seems like that's a very hard place to get to.
I know as a sports bettor, you probably do appreciate Mike Zimmer, just one of the most consistent coaches against the line over the last career, basically.
Right.
So sure bet, Mike Zimmer, for sure.
You are right.
I think last year, too, part of the trouble was they had this weird thing where they had like 18 draft picks, which is something unique. You don't see, obviously, too much in the NFL. I think just too many new guys just caused that to be a bit of a problem for this team. Obviously, losing veterans like Everson Griffin off of your roster, too. I don't know. I think this might be a transition year for the Vikings. They drafted Kellen Mond. Potentially, they might want to get younger, more athletic, cheaper, particularly with, in Kellen Mond's case, as a later draft pick. So that might be the most exciting things that Vikings fans have to look forward to this year.